Welcome back to Dracon's Plays, Dark Souls 2. Alright, so I'm warping back to Strayed Cell. Because there's stuff this way we want to explore. Yep, that worked. 10 out of 10. Alright. Yeah, I believe that item is not super duper valuable. Wow! Wrecked! In a twinkling. Racing knuckle ring. Okay. Flame butterfly. Torch. Quite something head, therefore be wary of plunging attack. Soul of a Brave Warrior, Golden Wing Shield. All right. Let's see. Ooh, that was almost bad. All right. So I need a fragrant branch of yore. I can't remember where I get one. I know she sells one. Yeah. Malencia sells one. Expensive, flashy gear will not always make life easier for you. Sometimes you just need your tried and true equipment to last the long haul. Okay. Yeah, so I need a fragrant branch of yore. I can't remember. I think you can get one down in Sinner's Rise. Yeah, because Sinner, if you didn't get the antiquated key, without the antiquated key, typically what you would end up doing is using a fragrant branch of yore to go fight a different boss that loops you around. Yeah, the gate with all those exploding guys in front of it, that is where you would normally come out. Got him. Lacerating knife, so that's a knife that causes bleed. Such crap. I'm gonna have to do something else there. Oh boy, he's gonna be a problem. Totally ridiculous that they put an archer right there. In the original version, there were three right there. Use this to restore health. Got him. Visions of S.H.I.E.L.D. Try gesture. Locked. All right. Off for allies, so there must be a summon sign there. Locked. Okay. It is dark. Body there, no item. Soul of a proud knight in a Pharos lockstone. So there was a Pharos down here, not. So I need a fragrant branch of yore. I might as well get all this set up too while I'm here. I won't actually do it though. Radiant Life Gem. Oh, I can't actually. No, I can't do it. Oh, that's unfortunate. Okay, so I need that key. Right, so I'm gonna have to get the key then, or the fragrant branch yore. I'm gonna have to get that one at Majula. To unlock the next boss, which will give me the key that I need to open a few of these doors. Yeah, it would open those five that I just ran into.
I need
12,000.
Take these if you want them.
What do you got? Covetous silver serpent plus one. Yeah.
Lovely time.
Soul of a brave warrior, that's 5K. It's only 5,000 to go up a level. Let's see how short I am before I go and pop any more souls.
Bearer of the
I need 6,000. So 2K more. Dang it, something went wrong with calculations. Oh, come on. Really? I need to get below 50. So close, I'm like right on the edge of what I can deal with this. Okay. now to... No, Tower Apart. Now, I can't remember if there are any, like, super important summons for, this next fight. Alright, use the fragrant branch of yore. Here we go. Oh, that spacing. Oh. Got him. That could have gone better. Makes no sense that those dang things are blowing up. Radiant Life Gem. Soul of the Proud Knight, some human effigies. Hurrah for rolling. Indeed. Okay. Weird. Alright, so I've used two Estus. That's not great. especially with how this next boss fight is. What do we got? Pilgrim Delclaire. Is that just a random... Okay. Do I just want to go for it, even with missing Estus? Alright. Got one. Really? That was delayed. I was doing so well. Why'd the second one hop up so fast? I wrecked that first. I can totally do that. Like, no problem. Okay, I have 8 life gems. Why the heck to that big guy? Why did that big guy aggro? And then I panicked and really stupid stuff happened. Well, incredibly stupid that guy aggroed. Oh. got attack. I hate manual attack aiming. Why the heck are you aggroing now? Why do barrels blow up when fire doesn't hit them? It's like no one has a fire-infused weapon. Why are they blowing up? Like, seriously, this is ridiculous and very, very stupid. Why the heck is that guy aggroing now? I've never seen him do that before, and he did it twice in a row this time. It's like I've never seen him aggro before, and now he's done it every time. What the heck? Well, that was weird. Oh, that phantom was... All right. All right, one down again. Come on, number two. Oh, you've got to be kidding me. Ah, crap. $44,000. Nice. There's one. Yeah, so their boss arena is full of treasure. Target shield. That's a good parrying. Rusty coin. Let's see. There's totally one right there. Hush. Homeward bone. Funny guy. Alright. Like, seriously, my weapon just beasted right through them. The issue, though, was apparently getting to them. And it's like, I should have beaten them on that first try, but the dang fall damage on this game's stupid. There it is. There we go. All right, so I'm gonna take a look at their souls, the few other things we got, a little bit more into our levels. Soul of the Rune Sentinels, a creation of the Jailer. The Rune Sentinel has no corporeal form. It is only an empty soul that haunts the armor. Curious. Alright. Alright, that's the Blossom Kite, so that thing slowly heals you. Hush. The Eastern Land of Moriah is not only the home of Crowd Knight, there's also a traditional order of Shadow Knights who quietly carry out unspeakable tasks. We also gotta admit, throughout history, there have been many examples of imaginative Miracles. When discerning original from imitator, is nigh-on impossible? Which hardly matters. Oh. And with fireball? Yeah, nothing there. Okay. Alright, so let's...
Bearer of pistols.
Getting some serious leveling up. Let's see. 30 vit. There we go. Alright. Now... put a bunch into endurance. That way I can have a little bit more freedom with my swings and rolls. The next one costs 7,100. Alright, so that's worth 8,000. 1,800. So that would bring me up to 7,100, right? I can totally do it. So much for that. Alright, to the servants' quarters. Alright, so I'm gonna have to look up which... So there's a ferrous lockstone in the room down below. I'm gonna have to look up what it actually is. Lesser foe required ahead. Gotcha. Another twinkling. Large club. Metal chest down here so it can't break. Priest chime. There's a Pharaoh's lockstone. I can't remember what's back there. And we're gonna save it. I am destroying those pursuers that are showing up. It's like, I remembered there were a lot of them. I didn't remember there were that many. Where is it? Door? There's that key. That guy actually jump scared me a little bit. that one choppy because it was an animation. Crap. Alright. Wow. We're most of the way through the Lost Bastille now, and I have the key. Which means I can gain access to the area with the Lost Sinner. Dang you, manual attack aiming. I should have used Estus because I'm running very, very low. There we go. All right. That's not what I meant to do, but there's nothing there anyways. Okay. Flame butterfly. Large self nameless soldier. All right. Now, there was a thing here that I couldn't open, correct? Okay. Hmm. bunch of life gems. Right, so that leads up to Strayed Cell. Oh, there's a door up here that I haven't opened. Yeah. There we go. Petrified Dragon Bone. Okay, that was worth it. Where the heck? Do I go for that? I'm very confused. Because it's like, I know there's a bell tower thing. Is that bell tower? Because I know is that what's in the servant quarter? I'm going to use the lockstone. I'm just gonna do it. Yep. Okay.
The bell belongs to the princess, it do. Stay back or we slice into bits.
Me and my chums, we shall be met.
Stay back all your pieces. Tiny's pieces.
Here we go. That's what I was looking for.
A long, long, long time ago, the princess she made. Yes, just like so.
Guard this bell for the prince's honor. Stay away, foul undead, or you'll be a goner.
Little rhyming there, pal.
Stay back! It belongs to the princess, it do!
Little Normally you don't start off by laughing before anything is said.
You wish to guard the bell, you do. For the prince and the princess forever.
For true.
Sure. Bellkeeper's seal.
Round the bell, you'll be brought near. When the bell is in trouble,
the ring brings you here.
All right.
Silence, whoever they are, wherever be, they live and they come. Slice them to pieces, for the princess.
Okay. He's a little crazy. All right. All right. The twin bell symbolizes the bond between two lovers who could never be united. The bell keepers are their eternal guardians, for that is their love, that is their curse. Okay. Well, I'm going to wrap that one up here. Next time, we're going to go take on the Belfry Luna, and then on to Sinner's Rise. So I'll see all of you guys later. Bye!